Games of chance. Not the way we play. Seconds, centers, bottoms, stacking the deck, mucking cards, the tools and terms of the trade. But just having a pair of hands ain't enough. If you don't have the stones to move under fire, you'll never get the money. So you work in fast company, hone your chops, learn to deal with the unexpected. And that's how you become a pro. That's how you become the dean.
Oh man, we gotta play some cards or what?
Everybody freeze! Don't anybody move! Come on, get your hands up! Put your hands up! The is this? Huh? What is this?
What are you talking?
You guys know who's running this game?
Shut up, you fat! Get your money out!
Get your hands up!
Look, I'm not gonna do anything, okay?
Get him up now!
Okay.
The appropriate term here is...
You lads are colluding, mother...
Fill it up, please.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh,
you all right?
I just took my ring off in the washroom. I just dropped it. You or anybody else finds this ring? Actually, it was really expensive. Whoever finds it, I'll pay him $1,000 reward.
Why don't I give you $100 for it?
This ring is worth more than $100. Don't waste my time.
Well, how much you want for it?
$260, $280, $300.
How much you get?
Time, Homer.
Hey, Charlie, Van Morrison, Vegas.
Van Morrison, count me in.
Jack of clubs, nine of hearts, eight of spades.
All in. I call.
All bets are in, gentlemen. On their backs. Three nines, pair of kings. Turn.
Ouch. Oh, God, that's gotta hurt.
Three kings.
Maybe you're ten. But I really need a nine.
River.
That's how we do. Oh, this is great.
Thank you. And you are a 10. I know you thought I was bullshit.
Top five.
Hey, Larry.
Hey, dude.
How you doing?
Yeah, I'm handling mine, taking all of it.
Mm-hmm.
You?
Big man.
Yeah, you bitch a ponytail.
You know, Miller's here.
Who's that?
Come on, Miller, the guy I was telling you about. So, Larry, this is Charlie Miller. Miller, this is the Jennings, Larry Jennings.
Larry, that was pretty hot downstairs.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's all right.
T tells me that you played pretty good yourself.
Now and again, yeah.
Yeah, right.
Can I get you some drinks, guys?
Yeah, I'll take a refill.
Okay, Charlie, you still JD on the rocks?
And a bucket, baby.
You got it.
So, Larry, what do you know so far?
Well, what I do know is that you and your partner found some seats at a soft game, and you guys have been doing pretty good on the regular.
Yeah, that's right. It's taken quite a while to set it up, but it's beginning to pay off. Yeah, it's worth it. 10 to 20,000 a game.
10, 20,000? That's nice.
Well, we could be doing a hell of a lot better, you know? If we had a third player, we'd tear this game apart.
You're making money already. How did I become the lucky guy?
Well, it's pretty obvious that you can handle yourself well in a game, and Tiffany says you're cool, so...
Can I get you a drink? Well, Hey, can I get you some of me?
Original. No, actually.
I'm Jeff.
Go away, Jeff.
Well, where do you think you're going? Come on.
Hey, listen, get out of my face, Jeff, or I will gladly shove my heel down your throat.
I like the sound of that.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Will you stay here and think about that, Jeff, while I walk away?
Well, consider me interested.
You gotta raise at least 15 to 20,000.
15, 20, what? You want me to give you the money? What, you trying to pimp me now?
It's the stake we all put in. It's a cash-only game. We need playing money.
Come on, baby, I thought you'd be interested in this. Charlie's come all the way down here. You know, but it's okay. Maybe he's just not.
I know Charlie came all the way down here. The money is no problem. The point is that I don't know him. He doesn't know me. And I don't want to be the one wearing the thong at the end of the day.
For fuck's sake, we're going to be giving you the money. Not the other way around.
This is a hell of an opportunity, Larry.
What about the third musketeer? When do I meet him?
Down 20 grand, I'm just great.
Any chance of raising the limit on this table? Could be $5,000 a hand. Let me see what I can do.
What the f*** are you looking at? Your tits.
Yeah. He wants to raise the table limit to 5 G's a hand.
He's on a fresh shoe. Fade him.
It's done. 5 a hand.
Damn nice of you.
Dealer bust. Good work, ladies.
40 G's for half hour's work. Not bad.
You bet.
There's your cut. Sure you don't want to reconsider Reno?
Oh, yeah, I'm sure. Besides, Jackie's good enough to pull it off. Good enough for Reno, anyway.
You got something set up?
Oh, me?
Great. I'll be in town later this evening. Okay, see you then. Thanks. God, I wish the mob still ran this town.
So do I.
This is a hell of an opportunity, Larry.
So what about the third musketeer? When do I meet him?
Meet him anytime you want. You can meet him now if you would.
So how do we know this is gonna pay off?
Listen, come to this address in an hour. Go to the back room, ask for me. I'll be there with my cards.
The cards come funny to all of us. How are you gonna fix that?
Yeah, look, Lady Luck can be a bitch at times. But fortunately, the guy that we're gonna meet, my partner, he's a... Larry, do you know what a mechanic is?
Christ, I can see the brief from here.
I'm not even dealing deuces, asshole.
Pretty ugly-looking tops, then. Maybe the chaps are getting rusty.
Is that so?
Big slicking clubs, two-handed. Pretty good. Did it get the money?
Yeah, but... I always preferred American Airlines myself.
Son of a bitch.
Well, good to see you're keeping the hands in shape.
That's a hard habit to break.
So what happened, Vernon? You disappeared like a ghost after the Ross came.
I just needed to get away for a while.
Oh, yeah? Well, for what it's worth, Tiffany and I were... we were worried about you. Thought your gun sailed because you'd taken some heat. Wasn't the cool thing to do.
Yeah, well, neither was Atlantic City. So, how is Tiffany?
We're great. Really great. She is an amazing woman. You know, I never thought...
What's the word on the game? Are we set?
Yeah, I'm starting at the game. Just gotta get your head in a moment. That guy I was telling you about, he's coming here in a few minutes. I want you to... Speak of the devil. That must be him.
Hey! And the devil appears.
Come on in.
Yeah, I heard you were back in town, but, you know what hurts me most? God damn it, he didn't even call.
I must have slipped my mind.
What the f*** do you want, Scotty?
The f*** do you think I want?
You know, we're kind of in between jobs at the moment. Why don't you come back in a couple of weeks and, you know, we'll see what we can do.
Okay. I'll tell you what, can we make that on a... Jesus,
come on, Scotty. You don't have to do that.
You see what you made me do?
We all have anything going on right now, okay?
Bull. If you didn't have a line on something, you wouldn't be back here.
He's telling you the truth. The only way...
Ho, when I want your opinion, I will dial your asshole.
I'm kind of tapped at the moment. All I got is a nickel.
Yeah. Jesus Christ, you weren't kidding, were you?
Hey, we're in a recession, didn't you hear?
Well, whatever. But just remember, boys, I want my cut, and I will get it one way or another.
How's your leg, by the way?
Still hurts when it rains. Son of a bitch.
Yeah, do yourself a favor, Scarney. Keep to extortion and leave the real work to the pros.
Pros.
Here, Skinner got run over by a car.
Yeah. Unsolved hit and run. Real tragedy.
To protect and serve, huh?
F*** off.
Some things never change, huh?
We are going to dial your asshole.
Oh, shit. Who is it?
Jennings.
This is the guy T was telling you about.
She says you know your way around the game.
Just got lucky. So Miller says that you're the real deal, Holyfield with the cars.
I can handle a deck pretty well.
What is this, modesty night? Show him something.
Four aces.
Kind of dope.
I told you he was good. He's a goddamn artist.
So you know the situation. We need a third to take down some of the big pots. If the same man keeps winning, it arouses suspicion.
It's a big game. Soft game. Guys go all their lives trying to get into a game like this. So we got to be really careful how we handle it. We need top-notch men.
Huh? So what do you want me to do?
You play on the square during most of the game. Except on my deal. Like your hand?
Get the Now they with that copper feels. Yeah, I like my hand.
That's what's known as base or bottom dealing. But I will vary it by stacking as well and dealing the punch, whatever it takes. But, you know, don't worry. You'll end up a winner every time.
Oh.
So, are you a man?
I'm a f***ing job.
Great.
For sure.
And we'll give you most of the stakes, so don't go blowing out a hunch. Just save it for the sure thing on my deal, okay?
Here's, $5,000, $10,000.
With your 15, that's 25. That gives us enough money to play. But you are gonna be the one making the big bets. You are the one gonna be taking down the big pots, okay?
I'm good with that. I like big. Show me.
Mr. Charlie Miller.
Hey, Charlie.
And this is Mr. Jennings, who will be joining us tonight. Would you sit there, Mr. Jennings, please? Thank you. This is Mr. Andrews and Mr. Osi, Mr. Leipzig. Charlie, of course, you know, Dr. Daly, and Mr. Vernon.
Good to meet you.
Call me Larry.
Mr. Jennings, we play regular poker here. Stud, draw, low ball, dealer's choice, no limit. And, of course, I take a small percentage for the house.
Yeah.
Well, have a wonderful game, all of you, and good luck.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, high card gets the deal. Good luck, everyone.
You get the ace. It's your call.
Let's ante up, gentlemen. Nothing fancy, nothing wild. Just pray for cards that make you smile.
Corny corn.
Baddest guitarist in a white band, Ace Frehley. Three Ace guys.
Yeah, I know you're in for that $25. Come put your kids through school. Grade school.
What?
Shit. Nice ass house, man. We should be playing some bigger hands, you know what I'm saying? I mean, we men or what's going on? I done came all the way up here, got a suit on and everything. What's with the arcade money? You gonna throw some logs on the fire, let it blaze a little bit?
Ace bets.
You know what? I'm gonna get it cracking already, all right? Let's pop this cherry, shall we, fellas? Can we do this?
Go ahead.
Can we do this? $500.
Oh.
Spend some of that HMO money.
I'm out.
Too rich.
Too rich.
I'm out.
My man.
My man.
Okay. You out?
Out.
Then stay out. Me and my man will do it.
Holler back. You know what I'm gonna do? Since I done already popped a cherry, I'm gonna take it out for a date. That's 2,000 right there. Now what? Huh?
Take it.
Take what?
Take it.
Come on, man. Y'all got to be bullshitting with this, man. I spend more than this in a strip club.
You wanna tell me how to play cards?
I'm not trying
what, you want my chips too? What?
I would like to get some of those chips, but I can't get them unless you put them on the table.
Man, I thought we was gonna be playing some big time.
A drink? Mm. What is these? Chips? Potato chips? Come on, man, this is poker. Come on, $200. Somebody bounce with me.
I'm out.
I'm out. You pushed me out.
I'm out. Me too.
You fold too.
I'm with you, bro. Just keep it black. It's 200. Raise you 200 more. That's for Jesse. Keep hope alive.
I'm going. Okay, well, I'm gonna keep it black like my ass. And I'm gonna raise you $3,000. Check your rent money. What's your Wang Dang look like? Hmm? Come on, black.
It's too rich for my blood, bro.
Come on, man. It's supposed to be a big game, man. We're supposed to be playing some big money. What is this? G15. Bingo. Y'all playing bingo on this bitch because you ain't spending no money. Come on, this is bullshit.
I think it's time we took a little break, gentlemen.
Sounds good.
Great. You got some Kool-Aid in this motherfucker, is this?
Did you get this big mouth?
Take a break.
Thought we had a civilized game.
Everybody calm down. I can't believe it. Fight out there now.
Well, you want to tell people how to play poker, maybe you could open a school, Leipzig.
I can tell you about the hair on your chest.
What? You cool?
Oh, no, I ain't cool. 5 pair of hands, I'm only up a few hundred dollars.
Man, it's not an exact science. You just have to wait for the right time.
Hey, this is wasting my time. I could do better by myself.
Relax, will you? You cannot control how the other players bet. You just gotta wait your time, be patient. It'll pay off, I promise you.
Yeah, it better.
5-card draw. Nothing's wild.
Drinks, gentlemen?
We don't need no drinks. We just need to play. Let's get it cracking.
Let's do that.
Good?
Good.
Looking good already.
All right, start with 100.
You're 100 and 200 more.
300 to me. Let's do 3 more.
6 to me. Make it 4 more. Or even grand. How about that?
I'm out. Gone, huh? A little thick. I see you grand. And I'll raise you 2 granddaddies. That's 2,000. Holler back.
I'm out.
A man with style is a man that can smile. I'm out.
Just come out with a rap out.
2 grand to me, I will take a look at my cards. Call that.
I think I'll follow your lead.
Cards, fellas?
2, please.
2.
How many? 1.
1 card like my bitch. The dealer takes 1.
All right.
Holler back.
2 grand again.
I'm out.
Come on, brother. Nothing, huh?
Well, what the hell?
It feels about like it's 12 G's.
All right, well.
It's getting hot. It's getting hot in here.
I'm gonna say 5 grand more.
Well. I assume cash is acceptable, right?
Of course.
Because I happen to have a little bit on me.
Jesus Christ.
That calls your belt right there. That's $82,500. No limit, right?
So the bitch gonna buy it.
Or it's bought.
Excuse me, Mr. Jenner. Is my marker good here?
Of course. What the hell? Hold on, what the hell is that? I'm American Express up in here? What is this marker? Look, if you don't have the chips to cover the bed, then you
fold. Excuse me, but I have the money. I just don't have it on me.
I got a jet. I just didn't buy it here.
Mr. Jennings, I can assure you that he has plenty of money, and he always pays his debts. Now, his marker is good at this table you are called.
It don't matter. Only have 4 girlfriends in my life, and they was all 10.
Excuse me. I guess every one of those girls was a guy named Jack.
Ooh.
Take a look.
Hey, let me explain what I'm saying. Look, this money is not the money that I'm trying to bet with. Let me give you an IOU.
A little cab fare. There you go. Katie,
can you take this IOU?
Weeks. This the cash right here is not the money I'm supposed to, whatever your name is. Look, my man, let me get you an IOU.
What were you thinking, Larry? You were told just to bet on Vernon's deal,
yeah,
right?
I know.
Yeah. And what's you pulling out the big bankroll?
Because I had a 4 of a kind.
Okay. Just relax, man, relax. You know what? We're gonna get those sons of bitches the next time. Look. But you gotta start listening to me. You gotta start getting with the program, Larry.
You don't understand.
Listen, if you're short of some cash, I can give you a couple of hundred.
A few hundred dollars ain't gonna do nothing for me, man. I'm telling you.
That just went swimmingly.
Are we not clear, Larry? Only bet heavy on my deal. That way I can control the outcome. You know, cheap.
Man, I don't want to hit right now.
Larry, listen, listen. This is just a bump in the road. We're gonna get this back tenfold.
Yeah, only if Nick the Greek here learns to control himself.
Would you leave him alone? Leave him alone. Relax. You'll get back twice what you lost in a couple of weeks. I swear.
I don't have a couple of weeks. Damn! Fucking ain't hearing what I'm saying.
Hey, Larry. Nice to see you too. What the hell was that about?
He had a really bad night.
To your health. I wish that you could have joined me. They do a lovely lychee nut martini here. Respect. I think respect is one of the paramount tenets of human relations. It says in the Bible, thou shalt respect thy mother and thy father. I respect Mr. Malini. He has respected me as a father respects his son. We've respected you. But frankly, you disappointed us. Hello, Nate. Would you care for something to eat?
No, thanks.
You see, my friend here, he probably prefers a double king chili cheese with an egg on it.
And a shake.
And I respect that. Oh, excuse me. I'm vibrating. Hello? Marlo? Yes? Information, who is this? Is that so? I'll do that. Who is this? They hung up. No respect. You're hitting the hard stuff kind of early, aren't you? Yeah. Mr. Malini would like to have a word with you.
Right, ma'am?
Patience isn't one of his virtues.
Larry, I understand you're a very good card player.
Yeah, I mess around a little bit.
Do you?
Yeah.
I heard you're quite a billion motherfucking poker player.
Yeah, well, if that's what they said, then that's what it is.
How's it going?
It's got its ups and downs. You know, that's how it goes.
Ups and downs?
Yeah.
You know, I'm not much of a card player, but... would you say that losing $80,000 is a down?
Yeah, that's a down.
And would it be a down if I lost that $80,000 out of last week's take?
I said it would be a down, man. If you already know some shit, then you know. What's with the silly question?
Did you really think that you could lose $80,000 of Max's money and he not find out about it in this town?
Listen, I'm gonna square that away with Max.
How could you be so stupid, Larry?
I met up with these guys. This one guy could do anything with a deck of cards. They take me to this game. We're supposed to win it. I get carried away on this one hand, and I shouldn't have bet on it, and I lost. I can't blame nobody but myself. I didn't do what they said to do.
Did it ever occur to you that you were the one hustled, Larry? That your so-called partners were professional grifters? They were con men?
No, because they lost their money, too.
Well, I think we're all here.
This is...
well, this boy reached into his stash, and I thought I was like...
Hey, baby.
Job. You like that?
Hey, I said, don't you feel good?
The whole thing was a setup.
I got 60 of them.
You believe me now, Larry?
Fuck the head. Buffet.
Beautiful.
Get
your jacket.
Right. It was a pleasure.
Ow, favorite. No.
Son of a bitch, never knew what hit him.
Five card draw. Nothing's wild.
Work of art.
Drinks, gentlemen?
No, we don't need no drinks. We just need to play.
Francis brought in the drinks. Since Jack brought in the cooler. Cooler on his own deal. It is good to be back.
It's certainly turning out to be profitable.
I gotta say, you sure and I have to pick him, baby.
That's what I'm here for. This is a hell of an opportunity, Larry.
So when do I meet the third musketeer?
Anytime you want. You can meet him now if you like.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go cash out.
I'll call you later. He's pretty good. Where'd you get him?
A couple of weeks ago at another club.
Okay.
He had the Rolex. He had a brand new Lexus. He's made for it.
I've always said it, baby. You are the best.
You seen Vernon yet?
No, I'm seeing him later on tonight.
How is he?
Well, you know Vernon. Vernon's Vernon. You know how he is. What are you doing? You've got one lit already. Listen, if working with Vernon is going to be a problem, I...
What? Come on, Charlie. Don't worry about me. It's me. Got it. I'll meet you there.
Well, well, well. Looks like you're all alone now, huh?
Lucky me.
Who is that?
None of your business, that's all.
Do you know what a mechanic is, Larry?
So were you serious before? Is that your scene?
Scene?
Yeah, were you just talking, trying to get laid?
I'm into it, my dear.
Yeah, we'll see about that. Come on, Jeff.
Come on.
Okay, so what about a safe word?
What?
You know, in case one of us feels we're going too far. Okay, how about eclipse? Either one of us feels uncomfortable, we say eclipse, we take a time out.
Sure, baby, whatever you want. So how do you like it, Jeff?
Rough.
Teddy, I'm good. How's your family?
Oh, they're great. Great. Thanks. Say, surprised me a little to get that telephone call. I didn't know you still did this.
Yeah, well, I needed some fast cash, you know.
On the road with Miller.
Something like that. What did you say? You know, I can't hear you with that thing in your mouth. Rough enough for you, baby.
I gotta say, you sure and I have to pick him, baby.
That's what I'm here for. So you think Jennings will be back for more?
Fish like that always come back.
Yeah, I wouldn't be so sure.
No? Why not?
Jennings, he seemed... something was off.
Well, he just dropped his entire life savings in one hand. Tends to wig a guy out.
No, it was more than that.
You know, that's a trait you're gonna have to get rid of.
feeling sorry for the mark. The way I look at it, guy isn't smart enough to hold onto his money, doesn't deserve to have it. Right, babe?
He said it.
See? She understands. Let's go get a drink.
Come on.
Let's go.
Suspense is killing me. What's the word on the game? Is he sitting?
Yeah. He's in.
Holy.
Come on, guys. Who?
Dean. Stevens, that's him.
Dad Stevens.
The man himself.
I mean, this guy, he's a legend. He was younger than I was when he started playing the big time.
Big time? This guy sat down with gangsters, killers, mobsters. Not for the money.
No, just to hone his chops.
I guess that would do it.
It was one night in Philadelphia. All these mobsters sitting around the table. He's working the game, went out of nowhere.
Everybody freeze!
Place gets hit. Everyone's got their hands in the air. Everyone but Stevens. As luck would have it, he'd just gone south and was holding out. Well, the place explodes. A huge gunfight, and everyone but Stevens and one of the wise guys go down. Stevens and the other guy. But they end up in a standoff.
Yeah, and they had three choices. Start shooting, walk away and leave the money.
Or three?
We cut for it. High card takes it all. I know which I prefer. Nothing ventured. Nothing gained.
He walked away with 50 grand, not even a scratch.
Wow.
Maybe it's just a myth. Maybe Stevens made the whole thing up.
It's a great story, though.
Yeah. Now, guys will drop their entire bankroll just to say they sat at the same table as him.
The Dean.
Very long this time?
No, just a few days.
Was it business or pleasure?
Business.
Whoever takes the Dean becomes the Dean.
Well, he's never been taken.
Not yet.
Don't get so cocky. I don't want a repeat of Atlantic City.
Yeah, well, neither do I.
Well, I'll be damned.
Good to see you, Eve.
It's good to see you, too. Frank, it has been a while, hasn't it?
Yeah, it's been a while. You look good.
I do, don't I? You don't look so bad yourself.
Nice place you got here.
Yeah, a lot of work. Should have seen it when I first got it.
So?
So?
Well, I was just in town for this game when I thought I'd...
You hungry?
Famished.
So you saw Stevens play, right?
Oh, I sure did. Omaha, Nebraska, 24th of May, 1986. I'll never forget it. I saw him gut a mob that tried to set him up, and he did it in such a way that it was a thing of beauty. I will never forget it as long as I live.
Quit trying to scare me.
I'm not trying to scare you. I'm just trying to prepare you. This isn't some whale who sits down beside you and says, hey, please take my money. This guy can cut you into little pieces. You won't even know it.
So, Eve, are you happy?
Sure. I mean, sometimes, you know, it's life.
Well, it looks like things are really working out for you. I mean, you never know what's going to happen to somebody once they get off the grip. But I'm happy for you, really.
Thanks.
No husband or kids?
God. No. Not for lack of opportunities, though.
Of course.
I guess you're a tough act to follow. When you have your life savings riding on the turn of a card every other night, then paying a mortgage can seem rather mundane.
Yeah, I guess.
What?
Well, lately I've been thinking that worrying about paying a mortgage might not be such a bad thing.
Oh, come on.
No, I'm serious. More and more, it's starting to feel like work.
I know the feeling.
I'm starting to feel like this old gunfighter. It's like every game I go to, every town, there's always some kid who's dreaming about knocking off the team. And I used to love it. Everybody wanted a piece of me. Sitting around that table knowing that no one could even touch me. But these last couple of years, I'm just going through the motions and getting lazy, not caring, losing my edge. So I say to myself, maybe I ought to retire, go out gracefully, before some kid comes along and just rips me apart.
One small problem. We need 250 to get into the game.
It's quite a stake.
Prime rib.
The way I figure it is this. 6-7 round the table, the pot's $2 million at least, just for starters. I've got $100,000.
I don't know. You really think you can take Stevens?
The dean retire? That would be first.
Hello, Eve. Seeing how well you've done just gets me thinking.
Thinking can get you in trouble.
Maybe I don't know what the hell I'm talking about. So, are you a restaurateur now?
Well, I'm still trying to figure that one out.
Do you think a happy restaurateur could be happy with a retired card man?
Well, I'll let you know when I meet one.
Maybe we should meet again tomorrow night.
Maybe we should.
Come to the game.
Come to the game, Eve. I might be able to come by when I close up.
I like that.
I always did love to watch you play.
But the best mechanic doesn't always win the game.
Don't worry. This time, I'll be patient. I'll wait for the right moment. And when he makes his move, I'll gut the son of a bitch in one hand.
That's what I like to hear.
Okay, I'm in. But I am coming to this game. I gotta watch over my investment.
Well, this puts us over the top. Guess I'll go make that phone call. Tell them we're in the game. You know what's really cool? We're back together again. The old team. Just like the old days. It's good to have you back, kid.
It is, you know.
Is what?
Good to have you back.
I'm not back. I'm just here for the game.
Working single up.
That's fine.
Must be sort of limiting, though, huh?
Yeah, but it's got its advantages.
Oh, yeah?
Mm-hmm. I don't have to worry about your partner stabbing you in the back. Or waking up with a kidney missing. Tell Charlie I'll see you guys tomorrow.
Do not sneak up on me like that. God.
You okay?
Yeah, just checking my messages.
So where did Vernon go?
I don't know, he split.
What do you want?
I need to talk.
Now?
Yeah, now.
You're such a moody guy, that Vernon.
Tell me about it.
Listen, now that he's back, there's a couple of things I want to talk to you about.
Oh, Charlie, I'm beat. I wanted to explain about Atlantic City.
I don't need an explanation.
Well, I need to. I didn't mean for it to happen.
I don't see the point. Once the game is over, I'm out of here, and you and Charlie can go back to, you know, whatever it is you have going on.
There is nothing going on. And we're just partners.
Last time I saw you two, it appeared to be a lot different than just being partners.
It doesn't mean anything.
Tell that to Charlie.
I was just frustrated.
Yeah, I can see how frustrated you are. Come on, T. I mean, nothing with you ever just happens. I don't know what your angle was, but I wasn't gonna stick around to find out.
There wasn't any angle. I just made a mistake. You know, you just took all that cash. I had a right to be pissed and upset. And Charlie was just there saying all the right things.
I should never fall in love with you. You had me feeling like a mark.
How can you say that? You were the only one I didn't have to play a role with. I miss that. So what are we gonna do about it?
We're not gonna do anything about it. I'm not gonna hurt Charlie.
You mean like the way you hurt here?
I thought you quit.
Well, you, smoking, all my old vices are becoming curses.
Tomorrow around 2:00. There's a couple of things I want to talk to you about. You know, personal. Just you and me.
Sure. I'll see you then.
Set me up, all right? That bitch had something to do with it, these motherfuckers. Look, I usually don't work like that. I usually work by myself. I should have been by myself. You know what I'm saying? They disrespected me in doing that. They disrespected Max. They disrespected everybody. Max is looking at me now like it's some, you know, some... Like, I would really steal from Max. Max is my dog, man. You know what I'm saying? It's just that I couldn't believe. I didn't see it coming, but I had a great hand, and then all of a sudden, I didn't have a great hand. The motherfuckers, they... They good.
I'm gonna take care of a couple things. I'll be right back. Don't worry.
Yeah, sure. Take care then.
I'm looking for Mr. Miller or Mr. Charlie Miller. Do you know him? You're kidding me, right?
corner booth.
I just need a change for the condom dispenser. Thank you.
Take a seat.
Are you Charlie Miller?
Charlie Miller. I know who you're talking about. Cool guy. Kind of handsome. You want to get a message, Tom?
I'll take that as a yes.
God, I'm hungry. Gotta watch the cholesterol, though. You want to split a chicken Caesar?
I have some important information for you, Mr. Miller, which may be of interest to you.
Oh, yeah, you're not one of those Jesus guys, are you? Because it's not
the... You're in way over your head, Mr. Miller, and you don't even know it.
Is that so?
You and your crew knocked off someone last night for 80 large. Don't worry, it doesn't matter to me how a man makes his living. Schmuck probably had it coming to him. I mean, it would be of no concern to me, except that the 80 grand that he lost was not his. It was his employer's. And his employer is a man by the name of Mr. Malini. Does that name sound familiar to you, Mr. Miller?
Malini. Yeah, it rings a bell, yeah.
And now perhaps you realize the situation in which you find yourself.
Listen, I don't know who the f*** you are, but let's just take a couple of seconds here to pretend I know what you're talking about. I ain't dumb enough to play with mobbed up money.
No, not on purpose, no. But you see, the problem, it still remains. The money, Mr. Miller. Do you still have it?
I don't. It's all been divided up.
And how much do you have?
Well, not much. I had some expenses.
It's unfortunate.
Yeah, I'm beginning to feel that might be the case.
And what about your crew? Of Vernon?
Listen, that 80 G's, no sweat to get it back. In fact, why don't you tell Mr. Malini this? Tell him to consider it in the context of a loan. And I'll keep the juice going, give him an extra 20,000. Let's say I'll have 100 grand in a couple of days.
2 days.
2 days.
100 grand. Mm-hmm. So you already have your mark set up?
Yeah. No sweat. No sweat.
I'll make sure that I get the message out.
You do that.
Oh, and one more thing.
Oh, yeah, what's that?
Give up smoking. It takes years off your life.
You know, it's funny you should say that, because I've been...
Hey, Charlie.
Muscle for Malini.
Malini?
Yeah, obviously Jennings was working for Malini. It wasn't his money to lose.
What, you think?
You were supposed to check him out.
Oh, come on, Charlie. I knew he was connected, but not connected.
Okay, calm down. Good timing, Tay. Saved their asses in there. You just have to figure out what to do next, that's all.
It's time to
time to get the hell out of Dodge.
After the game.
What?
After the game.
Are you insane? Mellini's connected all over L.A., Vern, and it's highway time.
We haven't gone through all this not to play in that game. Look, I'm playing in that game. You want to split? Feel free.
Shut up. Mellini's never going to find us that fast. All we got to do is lay low for a bit, that's all.
Where?
Let's get cleaned up. I know a place no one will look. Open sesame.
You're kidding.
No.
It's the magic castle. What?
There's no way Mellini's gonna find us in this place.
It's kind of amazing.
Yeah, I used to spend a lot of time here before I met Charlie.
Before I rescued you, you mean?
You okay?
Well, yeah. Other than being shot at, I'm great.
No, I mean you and me. Are we okay?
Yeah, we're fine. Right? Look, after the game, I'll talk to Charlie, okay? We'll work it out.
How's Vice doing here? You run out of hookers to bust?
Yeah. I think the last one I busted was your mama. Of course, no worries, she's out on bail. So who's this guy?
Not sure yet. We think he's connected to Mellini's crew.
Witnesses?
The waitress in back, she didn't see anything. People outside said they saw three people tear ass out of here just afterwards. Two guys and a girl.
Two guys and a girl?
Jesus, I don't believe it.
What?
Look.
That's great. The f*** is he still down here?
Who?
Professor.
Just put them down. Jesus, you have no idea what you're doing. That's horrible. Absolutely horrid. Go read Irnaz.
But I didn't even
It actually hurts me to watch you hold the deck. I suggest taking up a new hobby like stamp collecting.
So, Professor, what is the best advice you've ever given a card man?
Sleep with as many different women as possible.
Hey, guys, what do you think of this?
Not bad. Not bad. What do you think, Vernon?
Well, the move is pretty open. It'll work here, but forget about it at the card table. You need some kind of shade. I'd say make the shift with one hand as you ante with the other.
That's good. Very good. Boys, I'd like you to meet one hell of a card man. This is Vernon.
Professor, this is Tiffany.
Well, if I knew that hustling had such benefits, I never would have gotten into magic.
Why, thank you.
And you remember,
Miller. Surprised you're still alive.
Funny, I could have said the same thing about you.
Still hustling old ladies out of their Social Security checks?
Still pulling rabbits out of hats, Professor?
Boys, entertain the lovely lady while Vernon buys me a drink. Just don't pull any rabbits out of your hats.
Been a while.
Quite a few years.
What brings you here?
There's a big game at the Roosevelt tonight.
Your boys are gonna work?
Stevens is playing.
The Dean?
Yeah.
Yep. Be careful, he's damn good.
Oh, so are we.
Don't you mean he?
No, I mean we. Who do you think got your little magic boy here into someone who could make a real living?
And it hasn't hurt you at all, has it?
Give us a minute, Charlie, will you?
Yeah, look, there's some loose change over there on the floor.
Keep an eye on the clock, okay?
I want you to think of any card in any of the three rows.
Okay.
Look a little haggard, son.
It's been a long week.
Being on the grift is a tough life. It can wear you down. I've seen it before.
I know. You told me.
I'm not knocking the profession, my boy. Hell, I've been friends with most of the top mechanics and hustlers of the last century. I just hate to see you go down that road, especially with Miller.
He's not that bad.
He's a street hustler who's glommed onto you because he sees you have talent, and he has none, other than being a good liar.
We made a good team. I mean, what did you want me to do? Make a grand or so a week doing tricks for tourists? You know, I make that in one hand.
Of course. You just have to make a choice at some point. Is it about the art or the money? I remember when you and I used to stay up all night just discussing one move.
Yeah. I missed that. You know, I still don't have the finger floater on the bottom palm covered yet.
I should work on that. You always know where to find me.
Resident legend, huh?
Ask yourself if this is what you want to be doing for the rest of your life. It gets harder every day and every dollar. Just remember, some things are more important than money, Vernon. I've known a lot of mechanics and hustlers in my time. I've yet to meet a retired one.
Try room 808.
Thank you. We're in.
How do you feel?
I'm good. I'm loose. Okay, remember what I said. Play the man, not just the guns. Take your time. Be patient.
Good, Charlie. You're making me nervous.
No, nerves are good. Keeps you sharp.
Good.
Ready to do this? Okay, let's go.
Can I help you?
I'm looking for Mr. Hemingway.
Please come in.
Hey, now you must be Mr. Holden.
That's right. How you doing?
How do you do?
Mrs. Miller.
How are you?
And this is Tiffany.
A genuine pleasure, ma'am.
Thank you.
I'm Tony D from Austin, Texas. This good old boy is Mr. Thornhill.
Hey.
Call me Jack.
Hey, Jack. And if you'll allow me to introduce you to our host this evening, Mr. Mellini.
Good of you to join us, Mr. Holden.
Oh, it's good of you to have me. These are my friends. They tend to bring me luck. Any problem with them observing?
Not at all. I hope this will prove to be an entertaining evening for all of us. Now, if you'll allow me to introduce you to the other players.
You didn't know Mellini was gonna be here?
No idea. Great. Stay cool.
This is Mr. Stevens. Mr. Stevens? Mr. Holden.
Nice to meet you.
And you.
I hear you're from the Cincinnati area.
Yeah, around there.
Hmm.
Then you must know Ladybug Johnson.
I've met her. I don't really know her, though.
Too bad about her husband, isn't it?
I wasn't aware that she was ever married.
Oh, that's right. You know, I don't remember seeing you around the clubs last time I was around Cincinnati.
Yeah, well, I'm more or less a weekend player.
Right.
This is Tiffany.
Tiffany. Very expensive name.
Worth every penny.
Mrs. Miller?
Charlie Miller.
Dean, good memory.
You sitting in, Charlie?
Nah, me, no. I'm a dice man.
Really? You stake horsing?
Well, yeah, I guess something like that, yeah.
He must be a pretty good kid if he's willing to risk money on you. Charlie's very conservative. You're not a hustler, are you, kid? What do you say, Max? Are we to start this thing or what?
Absolutely. Gentlemen.
There you go. Can I get a receipt for that?
Yeah, after the game, Dice Man.
Mr. Holden, take your seat over there. Feel free to reload at any point. If the dean would do us the honor.
Sure, Max. Texas Hold'em straight up. Any gentlemen?
Call.
Well, what the hell? 10 more.
I'll just take one card, please.
I'm in for 1,000.
20 more.
That's it for me.
Up.
Well, Tony.
Yeah. Okay. Heck yeah, I'll call you. Let's see what you got there, buddy.
We got a big ouch.
Heck yeah. Well, I guess you won that one too.
Oh, yeah. Something says 5 more.
And I'll raise you another 5,000.
My goodness, I'm getting weak at the knees. As if I can dig down and get the courage to match that hefty wager.
Stevens is going to go for the kill, Tony Day.
Why don't we make it 50,000? That's 45,000 more. What do you think,
Tony?
Yes. I don't think I have that much with me.
Well, really, Tony, it's not that complicated. How much do you think you have, Tony, Anthony from Austin, or whatever, in that little saddlebag that you brought with you?
Well, let's see.
I'm sure you got a few more nuggets in that bag.
Appears I only have 25,000.
Now, I could be cruel, but you would think badly of me if I just bought the pot. So, Tony, since you flew in and you look like a nice guy, I am going to accept that bet. So, 25,000, it is to you.
I'm awfully sorry. What? Oh, no.
Easy, cowboy. Go off, let's go.
Bad manners, Tony.
It appears my evening has drawn to an embarrassingly dramatic close. Gentlemen. Ma'am.
Good night, Tony.
$100,000.
I'm out.
All in.
I'll call.
Trip tens.
Sweet.
As pie.
But I've got the nuts. He's a nice
bitch!
Someone.
So much for my lucky hat. Well, gentlemen, it's all for me.
I think I'll call it a night as well.
Very impressive, kid. And then there was three.
My lucky number.
How about 5 card stud from here on out?
Music to my ears.
Yeah, it sounds quaint.
And how about a break?
Are you, tired?
Just distracted, Cleveland.
Cincinnati.
Sorry, same state.
Back in 20 minutes, children.
Man, am I glad you came by.
Like I said, I always love to watch you play.
I like that.
How's it going?
I'm doing the obnoxious bit with this kid. Nothing seems to rattle him. He's good. He's just very, very good.
As good as you?
Why did you say that?
Charlie, you fix me a drink? You okay?
Yeah, I'm good.
You want me to get you a drink?
Yeah, I'd love a drink.
Keep your mind on the game. Do you folly?
Hey, count the chips on the table.
So how is he?
He's really good. I've double-duped him a couple of times and he won't bite.
So what do you think?
I don't know. You know, he's folded a few times with pat hands. It's like he's reading my cards.
So maybe he is.
Mark cards? Come on. I mean, Nadine's not going to use paper in a real game. That's just for hustles and squares. You don't use it in fast company.
Maybe he doesn't consider you fast company.
You know what? Let's find out. Come with me. See any edge work, sand work, no shade or flash. No block out of black line either. It's clean. Son of a bitch.
What?
It's juice. Bassett's using a juice deck.
Juice deck?
Yeah, look. It's a way of marking cards so you can only read it when your eyes are out of focus. Try it.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
I've only heard of juice sticks.
So what now?
Now? I think the dean is about to take a fall.
I think I'll quit while I'm still behind.
I guess it's just you and me, Cincinnati.
So romantic. King speaks.
4,000.
I like round numbers. Thank you, Ted.
King of Greece. King says bet. 20.
Make it 50.
King likes that. Cowboy still thinks big. That's 100 grand, son. Weekend player, huh? Last time I recall, ladies beat jacks.
If that's all I have.
Well, let's find out. 300,000.
Starting to feel like a healthy pot. $500,000. Short. 50 grand.
Really? Nothing ventured, nothing gained.
That's 3-0. 30.
Good to have friends.
You bet. All the way.
Looking for Mr. Hemingway.
I don't know any Hemingway. Sorry.
Oh.
Now you listen to me, you son of a bitch. I'll squeeze your goddamn balls to you in your bridges. Now, where's the goddamn game?
So let's see what you got up your sleeve, kid. What is this?
That's Vernon Miller. These are the guys who took Jennings for ADG.
I don't mind you. Hey, hey!
Jesus. Not so fast, Slick.
Put down your gun.
You so much as move your ass, your boss is...
Drop the gun!
No,
drop
it!
Melini, tell him to
what?
Drop him.
Drop it, sweetheart.
You, man!
You?
Drop the gun!
What the gun
Charlie,
down.
Shut up!
Put it down!
You see what I'm...
Watch your language.
Yeah? Eat my asshole.
Drop the gun, bitch.
I heard a lot about you.
Tell him to drop the gun.
Thanks.
Down the gun.
Melini, tell him to drop it.
Are you even looking for me?
Tell him to drop
the
gun, man. Drop him now.
Put it down.
Charlie.
Hello? Yeah. No, I don't know anything about a f***ing ring.
Things okay at home, are they, Charlie?
What is this?
Oh, thank God, it's the police.
Who are you?
Who am I?
Who the f*** are you?
Great timing, Scarney.
Another friend?
You have no idea.
Max, why don't you tell your boys to relax and you can take care of him after the game? All right. Now, I'm guessing that you and your friends are completely tapped out and I could buy this pot for, say, $10.
Don't bet on it, sweetheart.
Tiff.
Considering the circumstances, I'll let it pass. Let's see your card.
Do it, Vernon.
Trip Jacks.
Hell of a hand, kid.
Surprised?
You could say that. I guess I always knew this day was gonna come. It just ain't today. Three ladies.
that's not possible.
Anything is possible. Tough break, kid.
What does that mean, Charlie? What does that mean, Charlie?
You're good, kid. Really, you're very, very good. But as long as I'm around, you're always gonna be second best. Jesus. Hey, you want to get that thing away from me, please? You're making me nervous.
Yeah, making me nervous, too.
Not exactly a private place for murder.
Put it away. Jennings was an idiot anyway. I would, however, strongly suggest the three of you get out of the racket. Because if I see you again, I won't see you again.
About my cut. Forget it. Forget about it. You know, this almost makes up for my leg. See you around. Pros.
Nice play, Dean.
Here are your winnings.
Thanks.
I'll let you know when we set another game, Dean.
Sure, Max, but this is my last one for a while.
Do you?
Good night.
Hey, always recheck your hole cards. Hell, I was mucking cards before you were born.
The Dean, huh?
Hi.
You know, it's probably none of my business. But, Jennings never knew he was being conned. Someone must have tipped us off.
Who is this?
Seems one of your mules dropped 80 grand on a poker hustle tonight. One more thing. If you want the cash back, you might want to talk to a guy named Charlie Miller. He'll be at a bar.
No. Please. Let us know if we can be of some assistance.
Mm-hmm.
got a cigarette.
$2 million. I can't believe it. You let $2 million slip through your fingers.
He outplayed me.
Outplayed you.
Look, Charlie, I'll make it up to you, okay? The next time...
There isn't gonna be a next time, don't you get it? It's over. I wash my hands of you.
So that's it?
That's it.
Come on, baby, just leave him.
Well, this is familiar.
Yeah, well, it's over.
Oh, yeah. It's over, baby.
Sorry, there's not supposed to be any smoking in here. Hell with it. Go ahead. Stupid ass law anyway.
Thanks.
Good work, kid.
Everything except for Molini.
Oh, hell, there's always complications. Dealing with it is what takes skill. Which reminds me, it was a good call bringing in Scarney. Nice work there, John.
My pleasure. Thanks for coming in, gents. This actually does make up for my leg. Besides, I never liked Miller or that broad. Mean. Ooh, mean. Damn, sir.
So, did you get your answer, kid?
Fortunately, yes.
Oh, come on. Anybody can take a sucker. That's what they're built for. But to take down a pro, someone who's wise, your partner, now that's a real score. There's nothing more satisfying than taking down your partner, especially when they deserve it.
Yeah, that they definitely did. So you really out?
Oh, hell yeah. Gotta go out sometime. Might as well be while you're on top, right? What about you? You going back on the road?
Nah. I don't know what I'm gonna do, but I'm finished for a while. It's too bad, though.
Oh, why is that?
Well, you never got to sit at a table for real.
Yeah, that is a shame.
I always wondered how it would turn out. I guess one of us would have lost.
I guess so. See you around, Brian. Hey, Vernon.
See you around, Dean. Thank you.
controls my every breath. And Louis leaves me trembling. He knows I'll quit more. The lesson turns. Oh, the torture of his tears.
Bullets grip, the bullets grip are.